нами один из хедлайнеров Metal Condition Winter Hell, испанская группа Avus. Вот они как раз сидят, пьют пиво, общаются и, в принципе, ни о чем не думают. Ну, традиционный вопрос задам лидеру, вокалисту коллектива Avus, Дэйв Роган. Дэйв, could you please tell me, how do you feel in Ukraine in, now? Just the first question. How do you feel? How do you feel the people? How do you feel the audience?
We feel like when we played in Russia many years ago, the ambience in this kind of countries, Eastern Europe, is always very intense, crazy, and we knew that it was going to be like this, so we were pretty much looking forward to play here in Ukraine, and very satisfied and happy.
You see, we just communicated with bands, especially European bands, and some bands really afraid to come in Ukraine because now we have a war in here. So actually not in Kyiv, but in the eastern part. Don't you feel worried about coming to Ukraine because maybe something stopped?
Not really, because we knew that everything is happening quite far, and other Ukrainian friends we have told us there's absolutely no problem here. So many people in Spain is not well informed, and they think the war is in all country or something like that.
Yeah, actually, it's like in Israel, you know, it's fighting all the time. You know? So actually, we are all metalheads from all over the world. You know, we don't really want this war and fuck all the politicians. You know, here's a question: you run a label like Extreme Music. Is it really hard to do things like that in Spain? Because here in Ukraine we have no label actually, because it's impossible, because people are poor, you know, they cannot buy CDs, totally impossible. But what about Spain?
It's difficult because we live in a country that is in crisis since 6-7 years already, and also people like very much downloading and not buying original music. It's not like in Germany or France. Countries like that is good to have a record label, but Spain is not very metal country. We don't have support in general. So, but
what about the fest? Do you have some kind of a big festival in Spain? Metal festival, rock or something?
Resurrection.
Yeah, we have, but not legendary French or German. It's really
Sonisphere. Rock Barcelona.
I want to see a stand.
Rock
Barcelona.
Sonisphere.
You were talking about Ukraine, we call it death metal country because a lot of bands play death metal music. What about Spain? What kind of music the people listen the most, you know, like heavy metal, rock, or death metal,
Spanish pop. Spanish pop.
Spanish pop, it's a mix of flamenco with pop. Crazy here.
Here, a lot of people like Spanish music, like Spanish guitar. You know, everybody.
There are people like shit like Enrique Iglesias and shit like that. Yeah. You know, Shakira, that kind of bushy people like that very much.
Okay.
Latin music de mierda.
What band?
Very bad music.
which experience? What band just not strike you, but maybe impressed you? You are a very experienced band, you travel a lot, but what band really maybe was something special for you? Like some kind of a band, for example, it was something unusual maybe. What kind of, what band?
No, tú sabes que banda os ha impresionado así, que flipéis, en directo, que flipéis ahí.
Captain Decapitation.
A mí, pues,
Anto Flepa.
Metallica in the
80s. But
death metal.
Death metal music actually is music.
Unleashed.
Never seen it. We never played in French.
No, for sure. And I don't know. I remember no one as much. Gorefest.
Gorefest. Alright. Also, have never seen it.
The biggest.
Yeah. All the time I think, how can we move forward, you know, with all kind of the music? Actually, this metal music, it's music from 90s, or maybe you don't think like that, it's music of a new generation. Because you see, here in Ukraine, all the bands start to play some kind of deathcore, something more modern music. you many years you already play truly death metal music. How do you feel it? How you could be for after many years still on the trend? Such kind of music.
No, I think the true metal bands, despite of having modern technical or deathcore or emocore or things like this, despite of that, through all the style metal, death metal, thrash or whatever will always be there, and new generations will also appreciate it, of course. There is people for everything. I think we don't have to worry about that.
But just move forward, yeah. That's it. How many CDs we will see already produced for many, 20 years already, or 25 years?
24.
24?
Yeah, 25.
It's crazy. 20 years.
It's 91.
Yeah, so how many CDs you already have, like full CDs or some type of
album?
Album.
Six albums.
Six albums.
But we have like two EPs, then cover CDs. They have we have a split, also CDs with demos. We have like maybe 11 or 12 CDs.
Which CD, which album is most your favorite? Maybe. Which, what's it, oh, this is the best. Just listen, this is Lucid, or maybe all of them.
Difficult to choose. We have everything in every album, you know.
You have songs, you don't have favorites. I don't know. For me, it's.
Lucid have a very, very cool artworks. Who did artworks for you? Like, cover of artworks, very cool. You know, like, very bloody,
different
crazy. Like, with the things, I don't know how to name it, the things.
Challenge.
Yeah, the drum with that. It's crazy. First time seeing it. What?
The first album cover was done by Joe Petagno, the same Motorhead artist. Mm-hmm. And after that, we had other artists using Photoshop and stuff. Mm-hmm. And then we came back to more hand painted. And I think perhaps our best album cover is last album, Ritual Zombie. Is the most impressive album cover from a Spanish artist, Juanjo Castellano, and I think we will use him in the future also.
You see, you really understand the Photoshop or things like that. Also, okay, just maybe one more song about the label, you know. It's what can you recommend, maybe young band? Just to what kind of music, what kind of quality it have to be just to produce CD with your label. Maybe some advice, like it have to be like that.
Well, I have the lack of running my label based on my personal tastes. Mm. I'm not about commercial shit or business side, and I choose bands.
Just
I like it or
experience.
Not.
Oh,
I don't care if I know maybe a band I don't like, but maybe they can sell well. I don't care about sales. I only sign bands that I like. I would recommend the bands to work constantly, working hard, and keep the faith. If they don't get a deal with the first album, then maybe for the second or the third, play live and work. No.
For example, if I want to buy a CD from Extreme Music, what how can I do this? From internet, or maybe I have to write on your post, how it usually works?
We have a net of labels in every country. Mm-hmm. We do exchange of CDs. Here in Ukraine, we have trade with three or four labels. Mm-hmm. And people can buy mail orders in every country.
Okay.
So quite underground way. Only in a few countries like Germany, Holland, England, you can find the CDs in some record stores. Right?
When I stand like several years ago, I was in Canada, so I was like not a metal shop, like CD shop, and it was a lot of metal bands. Here in Ukraine, I don't have something like that. What about Spain? Can I buy, for example, a Volset in music CD, in music shop? Like, is it possible?
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe I have to go somewhere
in
the
Madrid. There is only one metal shop, Sun Records. Sun Records is actually the only. There were times when we had like a three or four metal shops, but now just only one. And well, you have a typical big MediaMarkt or Fnac or something like that. So you can actually buy Relapse stuff or things like this. But every time less and less.
Okay, I understand. Maybe you can recommend some kind of a Spanish young band that we never heard before. Okay, these bands from Spain are really cool also. Just can you maybe advise us something
Tragedy.
To listen some more?
Tragedy is a thrash metal band. Mm-hmm. Absolutely impressive.
Okay. Technical, melodic.
They are very excellent musicians and live they are top. So I would recommend this band.
Hey, you played a song that are older than your drummer, as you said. And how about him? Is it hard to accept him in a band? And it's a question for him, maybe you translate his answer. Don't he think that you are some older man?
No. This is a very good.
We know.
Really easy to connect with next young generation.
We know his father. We know his father since 25 years ago or something. We know his father. And he's a friend of ours since long.
Was
time.
He a friend of Avust before he started playing in your band?
Eh?
Was he a friend of Avust
yes.
before he started playing?
His father, us from the first demo of Avust, everything. And he's been listening to Avust since was.
I listen to Avust
when he was a
seventh.
How he feels first time when the Avust band invites him on the rehearsal and became a part of your band?
Great. Oh. Orgasmic.
Okay. Thanks.
Well, we want to thank Metal Health Mission for giving us the opportunity of playing for the first time in Ukraine. And well, we hope it won't be the last one. And we'll come here anytime. We are invited, so see you next time!
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Thank you.